This letter from SPR Selangor to all political parties in Selangor, those with assistant registrars, it will be distributed to you afterwards. I'll just read the letter. Untuk makluman yang bahagia Tuan Datuk Puan, sejak kebelakangan ini, hampir 50% borang pendaftaran pemilih yang dikemukakan oleh penolong-penolong pendaftar yang dilantik telah ditolak disebabkan penolong-penolong pendaftar mendaftar mereka yang telah mati, alamat tidak sama di dalam kad pengenalan mereka yang telah mendaftar sebanyak 2 kali serta terdapat juga mendaftar penduduk tetap. Keadaan ini disebabkan penolong-penolong pendaftar yang dilantik tidak mengikut syarat-syarat yang ditetapkan, iaitu berjumpa dengan bakal-bakal pemilih yang akan didaftarkan. Sehubungan dengan itu, bagi mengatasi isu ini yang dibangkitkan adalah diputuskan mulai tarikh surat ini dikeluarkan, which is 22nd of August. Maka semua penolong-penolong pendaftar dikehendaki menyertakan sesalinan kad pengenalan pemilih yang didaftarkan bersama borang A sesama mengemukakan borang-borang berkenaan kepada pejabat ini. Mana-mana borang A yang tidak disertakan akan dengan salinan kad pengenalan akan ditolak. Keputusan ini dibuat ialah untuk memastikan urusan pendaftaran pemilih lebih teratur dan semua penolong-penolong pendaftar yang dilantik adalah lebih bertanggungjawab. Sila pastikan surat ini disampaikan kepada semua penolong-penolong pendaftar di bawah penyeliaan yang berbahagia Datuk Tuan dan Puan. Sekian, terima kasih. This is a SPR letter issued to all political parties to be distributed to all appointed assistant registrars. And essentially, assistant registrars are to assist SPR in registering voters who are qualified but not yet registered. Now, with this new ruling that is to be enforced from the date of the letter, 22nd of August, it will be extremely difficult for us to carry out our duties. Now, first point, there's an admission from the SPR that there are parties, okay, who are trying to register those that are dead, those that multiple times, as well as registering permanent residents. Okay, this is an admission from the SPR that there are those parties who are trying to register those that are dead, and particularly those who are permanent residents. Okay, the solution is meant, okay, to solve this problem. Okay, it will, because if you are dead, you can't show your IC lah, so it's not possible. If you are permanent residents, if you photocopy, it's very obvious, it's a PR card. Okay, but it is a measure that is cutting off your nose to spite your face. Why is it chopping off your nose to spite your face? Because in doing so, solving your problem, you also prevent all the other legitimate registration from happening smoothly. Now, DAP has been assisting SPR in registering new voters actively even before 2008. And we have been commended by the SPR for having the cleanest set of data when we register. That means the number of mistakes that happen for DAP registration is the lowest among all political parties. And lowest meaning easily lower than 10% errors. Okay, that means we actually go out there to supermarket, to pasar malam, to offices to register new voters. Okay, we submit thousands. Like the last weekend we did a Shah Alam, the Selangor and KL wide voter registration exercise. We registered more than 4,000 new voters. With this new regulation, it makes our work extremely difficult. Why? When we go to Pasar Malam, where are we going to find a photocopier with a PowerPoint to register new voters? When we sit in the lobby of an office complex to register new voters, where are we going to find a PowerPoint
to put up our photocopier. We have got more than 50 assistant registrars. We have to go and buy 50 copiers for each and every one of them. I think the requirements for a copy of the IC is onerous, and it will severely limit the number of new voters which we can register, which is detrimental to the rights of these voters because there are more than 4 million still not yet registered. So instead of speeding up the pace of registration, we are actually slowing it down. Now, how can SPL deal with this problem? They should deal with this problem by penalizing the political parties that submit rubbish data. That means if a party or assistant registrar submits more than 30% fictitious date, permanent resident voters, terminate their assistant registrarship. Don't let them register anymore. And if more than 30% of a party's registrar maybe suspend their rights to register new voters for 6 months, punish the guilty parties. Don't punish the innocent parties like us. This particular ruling is punishing the people who really, the parties that really go down to the ground and register new voters. We meet the voters, we sign them up, we register new voters. And we only recently found that some new voters have been rejected, okay, for two reasons. One, the borang, the form, says tiada agama. Because in the borang, there's a lot of details. They ask for your telephone number, address, IC number, and they ask for your agama, okay? So some people put tiada agama. When you put tiada agama, it's rejected. Okay. Number two, when you put agama that is berlainan from the agama in your IC, it also gets rejected. I find this particular requirement onerous. Because a person's religion is irrelevant to his citizenship and the integrity of his data. Okay? SPL needs to confirm IC number, I completely agree. They need to confirm the exact name, agree. They want to even confirm the exact address, fair enough. Okay? But why should SPL be bothered with the religion of the voter? I'm no Malaysia.